Hi.
Hello.
How are you?
Doing great, thank you.
So you've come from everywhere, haven't you?
Yes.
So are you recovered? Are you ready, raring to go?
We are, feeling good.
Got lots of sleep last night?
Actually, I slept for 14 straight hours last night. You probably did
sleep. A long time. I did for my honesty, yeah, 15 hours.
That's definitely a record.
It's a record for me.
I don't even know if I could sleep for 14
hours.
This is
the most rested I've felt since my daughter was born, I'm pretty sure.
So you guys are on tour, been on tour for the God's Not Dead World Tour.
Yes.
Is that right?
Yes.
Do you want to tell us a little bit about that?
Well, we actually just finished it. Just came off a little vacation time. It was 65 cities in the States.
Grueling tour.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And all crunched within about 3 months.
Wow.
So we got to know each other extremely well.
Yes.
All done by bus in the U.S. And I think we went to almost every state.
Pretty much,
in that time.
That's pretty powerful to you. You think 65 cities in just under 3 months. God's Not Dead. What a message to share with the public. And a lot of unbelievers came out. An evangelical type tour. In the sense of we really directed it. We went in before the shows. Where people go into the cities and really rally the people, rally the churches to bring out their unsaved people and their friends. And that is what the gospel is all about. That's what Newsboys is all about, sharing the good news with the public, the people. So the tour on a spiritual level was successful. 6,000 people made faith confessions, 6,000 people. And the best part is that, but also an economical downswing in the States, the tour was mostly sold out. So that's a blessing also.
You know, we wanted the tour to be an encouragement to people, you know, and our culture too, because, you know, like here in the States, it's like our culture's kind of become one where we've become our own God.
Yes.
And I think there's a discouragement among Christians, like,
sure.
Where are we heading, you know? So I think it was something we wanted to present, like, we believe in God. He has a plan for your life. He is not just for old people and for,
children.
Yeah, he's got a plan for everyone, and it makes sense. It's not something, like, our culture has made it sound like you're silly if you believe in God, or, that's old-fashioned. Or, no, if you actually take the time and research it makes perfect sense. And so that's what the message that we wanted to encourage people with through that tour.
Brilliant. Have you found it really exciting to see young people being excited about Jesus while you've been on tour?
Also, that's the best for me. I love youth, and I think, as Jeff says too, as Daniel says in our band, Christianity is not just for old women and little kids. It's for the unsaved masses. And when young people are excited about Christ, man, That's the energy that I like to see it as well, because my dad always said, my dad was a church layman, a pastor, and you can always tell a thriving church, a strong church, because it's full of youth, and not just, you know, youth, but believers that are youth. So it's very powerful.
And obviously today's generation are tomorrow's leaders.
That's right.
So do you think you guys are like playing a part in making sure that happens?
I'd like to think so. I mean, hopefully we are.
I hope so. I mean,
God knows we're trying.
It's so funny because you meet a lot of people on the road, but you don't really see a lot of the impact because you're off to the next place the next day. But we meet a ton of people. I always think in my mind, whenever I meet an 8-year-old kid who comes up to me and says, "Oh, I love keyboards," and I'm like, that could be the next guy. You just never know. Like, I want my life to equal what that guy probably thinks of me.
Yeah.
And that's where the challenge is as a leader, to be someone in public, to be the real deal and to be an example. Like, leadership by example is the hardest
Definitely.
Way to do it.
All that to say, hopefully somebody's watching us, watching Jeff, and saying, you know what, man, this is cool what they're doing. They're doing it for Christ. It's not corny. It's impactful. I want to do that myself. So they're watching it.
Yeah.
Go for it.
Perfect. Thanks, guys, for joining me today.
Our pleasure.
And
thank
good
you.
Luck later
thank
on.
Thank you.
Should
yeah,
be fantastic.
Should be fun. Thanks.
I didn't want to fall, but I don't have to go. I'm not the one with Looking like you're living in fear, having trouble even looking at me. Wishing it would give you more than words, sick of people telling how it should be. What you download, where'd you get your info? It's all that hype show, now you're in the endo. Gonna tell you what I believe. Oh, this is what it is, this is who I am, this is where I'm from. Stars in my head, sing love will take us.
So the Newsboys are more than excited to be in the UK during the time of the Queen's Jubilee. We plan on spending time in London in a couple days, seeing the Queen ride along in her carriage, hopefully get a wave to her. But in all due respect to Her Majesty, we are a bit more excited about the fact that one day, the King is coming. So is it okay tonight if we could focus on sending praise tonight, if all of the UK tonight could join the Newsboys and giving praise and adoration to the King of all creation tonight? For God so loved this world that he gave, is a verb, as you know. Gave love, verb, phrase. I know my English. So tonight, can we go old school tonight? Don't cheer till you hear what I'm talking about here. Look at the person next to you.
Uh-oh.
Oh, actually, look at someone maybe you don't know. There's a concept. Look them in the eye. And don't look at me, honey. I'll be here all night. Look at them. Look them in the eye and say these words. I love you. I see you guys. With the love of the Lord. Now give him a holy hug and a kiss. All right, no more kissing. Side to side like this. The whole place, side to side, like one big black gospel choir. was a lot of white people. Here we go. Na 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 na. Oh, that's your part. One, two, three, sing it. Beautiful.
It's the song of the redeemed, rising from the African plains. It's the song of the forgiven, drowning out all of England's thunderstorms and rain. The song of Asian believers, filled with God's holy fire. Every tribe, every tongue, every nation, a love song born of a grateful choir. Come on. Let praises echo from the towers of cathedrals to the faithful gathered on the ground. All the songs sung since the dawn of creation, there are some that persist. Yes, they do. All the bells rung from a 10,000 steeples, none ring truer than this. Get your hands in the air. They just heard. And all the powers of darkness will never drown out.
can wash away my sins. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. No other fount I know. Nothing but the blood of Jesus.
I want to hear you sing that with me. Come on, let's sing it to Jesus. What can wash? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Can I get a hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
Can I get an amen?
Amen?
That's exactly how we do it back in the States in the chocolate church. And I got a feeling tonight, there's some of you vanilla folk here in England would do well in a chocolate church. You get that? You get that, huh? I grew up the son of a preacher man in the city of D.C. I'm the baby of nine kids. I have five older, abusive sisters. I love them all. Three older brothers and a dad that loved us so much. A mom and dad that taught us, man, when we were kids, that they will know you are Christians not by where you live, not by where you work, or the car you drive, how much money you got. They will know we are Christians by our love. And if we ain't loving, we ain't doing nothing. Say what you want. For God so loved the world that he gave. Love is giving, man. I'm not pointing the finger at all. I'm just saying, you know what, guys? That's what's going to talk to a world that's hurting, man. That speaks volumes. You can talk to them all day long about all kinds of other stuff. But if you show them love, you take time out for them. Buy him lunch, take him to church, Salvation Army. Just thinking out loud here. A lot of times back in the States, I find myself in my tour bus and in my bunk crying out to God saying, I want to do more, I want to do more, what can I do? You feel under or overwhelmed, like you're not doing enough. You may feel that way ever. You want to do more for God, but you feel like you're not doing enough. I found out one thing, guys. If I obey him, follow him in his precepts, follow the commandments, and love him, and love people, you're doing a lot. Tonight, those who came with a heavy heart, man, you're not by yourself. You don't know God. It's okay. Tonight's not for you to find God. Ask God to come into your heart, change who you are, give you a new start. Tell him all the dirt, all the dirty, all the junk. He knows it all anyway. He's God. Tell him all. Then ask him to save you, change you, give you destiny, give you hope, give you a future. And then one day when you go to die, and you will, you will spend eternity together in heaven with all born-again believers, because our God is mighty to save. Are you ready for some more rock and roll? On the lead guitar tonight, background vocals, the very talented rock star himself from the great state, back in the States, the great state of Indiana. This young man's name is Mr. Jody Davis. Give it up. Jody?
Yes.
Would you please bring the rock to England?
I will do my best.
Thank you, sir.
Been trying again, doing whatever it takes us to fit in. You're falling for the lies of the world. You tell me you pay anything just to not hurt. But what you want, I ain't got what I have.
there be? To you, if I told you this road that we travel would be smooth, but sometimes you just wanna give up, trying and trying, but nothing is ever enough. You're chasing things, but what for? You're seeing them all, but you want more. There's something better. From the darkness, get away from the darkness. I can see, know you want this, and you know that you need this. Get away from the darkness. You gotta know who Christ is. Mr. Frankenstein.
Hello, my friend.
This young man's name is Jeff Frankenstein. Give it up for Jeff Frankenstein tonight. He's our band leader and director. And he's from the great state of Michigan, the city of Detroit. And his last name is indeed Frankenstein. So tonight we're gonna call him Dr. Frankenstein. Dr. Frankenstein.
Yes, my friend.
What is your musical prescription for this crowd?
I've been studying this crowd tonight.
Sure you have.
And I have made it a diagnosis, and I have a prescription in mind.
What is it, sir?
Well, it's not every day that we get to the UK, true, let alone for the Queen's Jubilee.
Yes.
And we have been treated like royalty here this weekend. And so, in return, I say that we dig back into the archives, and we pull out a little gem and give it to these people before we have to go.
A little gem.
And that would not be it.
Breakfast song.
That also would not be it. Oh no.
Come on, man.
This is the UK. And these people need something, I think, just a bit more freaky. You know what I mean?
Separated, I cut myself clean from a past that comes back in my.
high. My faith is dead. I need a resurrection somehow. Now I'm lost in your freedom. And this world I'll overcome. My God's not dead, he's surely alive. He's living on the inside, roaring like a lion. God's not dead, he's surely alive. He's living on the inside, roaring like a lion. Roaring, roaring, roaring like a lion. Roaring, roaring.
Let heaven roar and fire fall. Come shake the ground with the sound of revival. Let heaven roar and fire fall. Come shake the ground with the sound.
Of your name,
Jesus,
Jesus, your name is
all of England I sing. With all creation I sing. You are, I will adore you. Thank you, UK, we love you.